Mickey Guyton became the first black female country artist to perform on music's highest profile awards show when she sang her Black Like Me at the 63rd Grammy Awards ceremony on Sunday. It's a hard life on Easy Street, just white painted picket fences far as you can see, she sang, backed by a churchy choir, in the mid-tempo cut built on stately piano and yearning steel guitar. If you think we live in the land of the free, you should try to be black like me. Released last summer amid the nationwide protests sparked by George Floyd's killing, the song offers a vivid reality check from an artist who's spoken frankly about the challenges faced by black artists in the overwhelmingly white world of country music. Guyton, 37, was nominated with Black Like Me for the Grammy's Country Solo Performance Award. As Trevor Noah pointed out in his intro, she was the first black female solo artist to receive a nod in a country category, but lost to Vince Gill, who took the prize with When Miami Prays. The remaining artists in the category were Miranda Lambert, Brandi Clark, and Eric Church. Last year, Willie Nelson won with Ride Me Back Home. The award for country solo performance dates back only to the 54th Grammys in 2012, when the category was created to combine the trophies for female vocal country performance, male vocal country performance, and country instrumental performance. No black woman ever won or was nominated for female vocal country performance. Ray Charles, who famously took up country music on his classic 1962 album, Modern Sounds in Country and Western Music, was nominated for Male Vocal Country Performance with Born to Love Me in 1984. He lost to Lee Greenwood's IOU, and the Pointer Sisters won a Grammy for Country Vocal Performance by a duo or group in 1975 with Fairy Tale. In 2016, Beyoncé reportedly submitted her song, Daddy Lessons, which she performed that year with the Dixie Chicks on the CMA Awards, for Grammy's consideration in the Country Solo Performance category, but the song was said to be rejected by the Recording Academy Committee overseeing country submissions. Guyton grew up in Texas, where her grandmother introduced her to country music. After high school, she moved to Los Angeles and eventually made the connections that led to her being signed by her label, Capitol Nashville, in 2011. As Julie Height wrote last year in a Times profile, Guyton envisioned a smooth progression from there. I thought I was going to come to Nashville, write all these songs and put a record out 2 years later, the singer told Height. Instead, Capitol waited until 2015 to release Guyton's debut single, Better Than You Left Me, which failed to attract much interest from radio programmers. Since then, the singer has continued to struggle in a country radio environment notorious for marginalizing songs by women and people of color.